We have already seen in the previous video how to find the residue of any function f of z. And in this video, we are going to learn about Cauchy's residue theorem, how to evaluate the integral using Cauchy's residue theorem. The statement of Cauchy's residue theorem is let f of z be a function which is analytic inside and on a simple closed curve z, except for a finite number of singular points z1, z2, z3, etc., zn inside z, then integral over z f of z dz equal to 2 pi I into summation of residue of f of z at zj, where j equal to 1 to n. Procedure to find an integral value using Cauchy's residue theorem. Step 1, first find the pole of the given function f of z. Then step 2, check whether the pole lies inside of the given curve C or not. Step 3, find the residues of each poles. If any pole lies outside of C, then their corresponding residue is 0. Step 4, now use Cauchy's residue theorem to find the integral value. For example, the question is, evaluate integral over c e power z divided by z the whole into z minus 1 the whole square into dz, where c is a circle mod z equal to 2 by Cauchy's residue theorem. The solution, first write the value of f of z. Here f of z value equal to e power z divided by z the whole into z minus 1 the whole square. And here 0 be a pole of order 1 and 1 be a pole of order 2. Because at these two points the given function is not analytic. Therefore, these are the poles. And these two poles also lies inside of the given circle mod z equal to 2. So now find the corresponding residues. And we know if A be a pole of order 1, then residue of f of z at A equal to limit z tends to A, z minus A into f of z. Therefore, residue of f of z at 0 equal to limit z tends to 0 into z minus 0 into f of z value, that is e power z divided by z into z minus 1 the whole square. Here z is cancelled. So we get limit z tends to 0 of e power z divided by z minus 1 the whole square. Now apply the limit, that is replace z equal to 0. So the numerator is e power 0 and the denominator is 0 minus 1 the whole square, that is equal to 1. And also we know that if A be a pole of order m, where m is greater than 1, then residue of f of z at A equal to g power m minus 1 dash of A divided by m minus 1 factorial, where g of z value equal to z minus A power m into f of z. Here 1 be a pole of order 2. Therefore, m equal to 2 and A equal to 1. Therefore, residue of f of z at 1 equal to g power 2 minus 1 dash of 1 divided by 2 minus 1 factorial, that is equal to g dash of 1 divided by 1 factorial. Let us assume this is equation number 1. And here we know g of z value equal to z minus 1 the whole power 2 into f of z value, that is equal to e power z divided by z. So we get g of z value equal to e power z divided by z. Now differentiate this equation with respect to z. We get g dash of z equal to, the right hand side is of the form u by b. And we know the differential value of u by b is equal to, denominator is b square, numerator is b into differential value of u minus u into differential value of v. Therefore, the right hand side becomes z into e power z minus e power z divided by z square. So g dash of 1 equal to e power 1 minus e power 1 divided by 1 square. That is equal to 0. Now substitute this value in equation number 1. We get residue of f of z at 1 equal to 0 divided by 1. That is equal to 0. We know by Cauchy's residue theorem, the integral value of f of z d z equal to 2 pi I into sum of residue of f of z at each of its poles. Therefore, integral over c is e power z divided by z into z minus 1 the whole square into dz equal to 2 pi I the whole into residue of f of z at 0 plus residue of f of z at 1, that is equal to 2 pi I the whole into 1 plus 0, that is equal to 2 pi I. Thank you.